most welcome guest. So it's perfect to always start with where you were to know where you want to be, which is why I think 2018 was a fabulous year in order to do that. Life is a path, it's a journey with twists and turns, ups and downs, places that you never thought that you would go. I'm going to start basically at the end of 2018 because every beginning deserves a proper ending, as it's all a revolution. As I say, New Year's revolution, not resolution, as I bridge into the new year. So the end of 2018 for me was a very strong, poignant moment because I had three things happen to me. The first one was I decided to let go of some old patterns that weren't working. I'm saying I'm not going to take this older stuff with me when I move into the new world because I'm a new woman with a new plan. But it led to the second thing that had to happen to me, which was a flushing out of the old, literally, as I got sick with the flu for about 14 days. And I thought to myself, the last time I was this sick was in 2009 when I left my ex-husband. So talk about a massive change. So if I can parallel that to say 9 years ago when I left my ex-husband, now I feel emotionally alive, spiritually alive, I'm feeling great. Physically, I don't feel so great, but I can take this flu and flush all that stuff out to then step into the brazen, brave new me in the next year. And the third thing that happened to me, along with the royal flush, is I decided I get to be me. That is my motto. I get to have my opinions, state them to people, and really be confident with who I am. So I had two friends that I said, you know what? I don't feel like you're as engaged in this relationship with me as I thought, you know, you once were. So here's an opportunity. This is how I'm feeling. This is what appeared from you to me in this relationship. And they both chose, because it was two people, they both chose to say, well, that's actually not what I want, and so I'm going to choose to end this relationship. So it was the end of the year, end of this old me with the flu and losing two friends, but never fear, there's always positive in the negatives. So now I can move into 2019 lighthearted and unloaded all that other